Hi, my name is Alexis. My job is to help you get back with your ex. And in this video, I'm going to explain you how you can get back with your ex in 30 days. I'll explain you the process. I'll explain you how to do it. I'll explain you what to do and say. I'll explain you the why as well. Well, I'll explain you everything after the jingle.
IGetMyExBack.com. Everyone deserves a second chance.
So why 30 days? So 30 days is kind of a makeup number, but it's actually, if you look at studies about how you change habits and how you change behavior, it's 21 days, 30 days, but it's really the minimum amount you need to be well prepared. So well prepared might be getting in touch with your ex, getting on that second date, maybe stopping their contact, all this kind of thing. So it's really, you need that time to be well prepared. Can you get back with your ex quicker? Yes, but it's, to be honest, not realistic, because it's really maybe 15% of my clients' cases. And it's not that I'm not good because I can't get them back quick enough. It's just because it takes time. And then I'll explain you why it takes time. So don't believe anyone, before I move on to the next slide, don't believe anyone who can guarantee results, whatever the situation is. Love is complex. Every single situation is different, is unique, and this is why I love my job so much, because every time I speak with my clients on consultation, I feel that it's something new, it's a new perspective, there's new things to learn. And also, I guess you share that thing as well, that if that relationship was unique, it's worth saving it. And that's why I think it's such an amazing job. Anyway, also be aware of people who provide you with a one-size-fits-all approach. Your couple is different than any other couples. Of course, there are mechanisms and dynamics that you can associate and compare with other couples, but it's really depending on you. And what I want you to do with this 30 days sort of challenge is for you to embrace and I want you to, I'm empowering you to do the right things. So it's really about how you take that knowledge, how you take that those methods and apply it to you. Now, getting back with your ex, as I said, is a process. It took time for your ex to break up with you. We usually say 30% of the relationship your ex thought about breaking up with you. Not that, let's say you were together for 3 years and they've been thinking about dumping you for 1 year, but they had that idea maybe a year ago, and they basically assessed over the course of the year whether staying together was the best thing for them. And so when they announced that decision, you think like, wow, that's very sudden, but maybe in their mind it's not anymore. And that's why it takes time to get them back. How can you get back with someone who thought about the decision for months? Just by talking them out, or just by buying gifts, for example. It takes time. And if you're looking for a quick fix, if you're looking for incantation, things that can manifest your love, this channel is not for you, and I would recommend you to find other type of content. The thing is, it takes time. You have to respect that. There's no shortcuts, unfortunately. I wish there was, but there's no shortcut. The thing is, what they expect is actually you to change. Expect the situation to change. And change, you can read about it online, find books of self-development, but change requires clarity, it requires time, and it requires dedication. There's no shortcut about that. If you want to change fundamentally for good, it takes time, it takes clarity, and it takes dedication. So this method can work if you've had a relationship, a real relationship. So a relationship when it was not one-sided, where you loved each other, where you had plans for the future. For example, you had kids, you were about to get married, we are talking about the future. Also another criteria, not that I'm doing ageism, but if you're above 25, because I've seen that a lot of situations where people are below 25, they don't exactly know what they want. I didn't know what I wanted when I was 25. And they can't really benchmark their relationship with other relationships. So the thing is, it can work if you're below 25, but honestly, I'm not so sure if it's gonna work. I'm sure it works for people who are above 25. Also, have you done anything that can be repaired? So, cheating, but obviously a lot of cheating, whether you have had a narcissistic behavior with your ex, anything about abuse, if there is a restraining order, all this kind of stuff will actually not work with my method. Another way to see if it works, if it could work for you, and it actually takes into account those criteria, is if you have 15 or above in my quiz. So the link is in the description, and also I think I will leave the link in the first comment of the video. Take the quiz, it takes literally 2 minutes, but at least you know if you have a chance to get back with your ex. It's totally free, obviously. And the number five, which is probably the most important of the five, is you have to be motivated, because I mentioned that there's no shortcuts. It's, you have to do it the hard way, because there's no easy way. You have to be ready to work and make progress every single day. And that's the thing. It's really about every single day. And that's why I want to emphasize on these 30 days. It's every single day. For 30 days, you make that effort. So what can you expect from that challenge? You gain more clarity. A lot of people, when after a breakup, they're lost. They don't know what they do. They don't know what to say. They don't know whether what they are worth. So it's really about gaining clarity. The thing is, you can also, it will also prevent you from overthinking. It's really also something that I did when I was when I got dumped in the past. It's like you overthink, like what if. You overthink about the future, you overthink about the past, you overthink about yourself. So you'll follow methods to help you stop overthinking. You'll be sure not to make mistakes, because it's really, the critical moment is not what you've done before the breakup, but usually after the breakup. This is when we have situations of break or make situation, is after the breakup actually. There's been studies about that. Usually what determines whether a relationship can be saved or not is not before the breakup, but it's after. Also, one thing that I'm very, very keen on is for you to minimize the amount of regrets in your life. Again, if you look at studies of people on their deathbed, they always regret the things they haven't done. So here is the opportunity for you to minimize the regrets and make sure that you do everything possible to recover the relationship. Will that work? I can't guarantee it, but at least you'll be sure that you've done the right things. And the last, but maybe not the least, is feel that you're not alone in this. So if you're watching this video in November 2021, you can join this cohort of people who are doing this challenge with me. If you're watching this video after, don't worry, you can still watch the videos, but you won't be able to access the WhatsApp group. But it's basically, I want you to also acknowledge that you're not alone with this. You can also benefit from my help as well. It's totally free, obviously. The idea is to group people and work together on that same goal. So the principle, and again, I told you I won't give you spoon-feed stuff, but I want you to explain you how it works. And again, I'm not making this up. It's the learning pyramid. It's something that has been used a lot. And it's to say, when you read, you forget. When you listen, watch, you remember. And when you do, you understand. And this is what I'm gonna do. When you watch my videos, you're in the read, listen, observing an image, but it's really slides, not really image. When you watch a film, you apply practice less so much again on YouTube. So what I want to do here with that 30-day challenge is to get you lower in the active part, from passive to active. Listening to my and reading my slide is great, but it's usually not enough. What I do with my coaching is that I push my clients to become really active. We are the bottom. We create, we evaluate. So what we'll do is, I want you to participate, to try, to do. It's really about how you can learn and how you can change. It's really important for you. Acknowledge, and it's not only me. Any video you watch on YouTube, you'll always be in the passive. You'll always be at the top. So now it's really about, and my cat is really in the active mode. It's not passive. So it's really how you can move lower in that pyramid and gain more clarity. Would that work for you? Yes, because you're going to increase dramatically the efficiency of anything you do when you watch a video. The other thing you have to understand is the compound interest and habit change. And again, I'm not making this up, something that you can read in Atomic Habits. It's really about the dramatic changes you can do in your life when you just change something a little bit, but you do it every day. And by doing that, you can have amazing results. So rather than thinking, yeah, I have high expectations for my life, but it's so much of a too ambitious goal, it's overwhelming, and getting back with my ex seems so distant, let's look at what you can do today to get you closer. And then tomorrow we'll do another one, and then the day after. And by doing that, you'll really doing the right things to change a habit. Because a habit is something that you do unconsciously, it's something that you do without any effort. At the beginning, when you start running and it's the first time you run, it's difficult, but then when you get into the habit, it's just like brushing your teeth. You don't think about it. You know, you wake up, you have your breakfast, and you brush your teeth. You go about to go to bed, you brush your teeth, and you don't have to think about it. You don't have to overthink about it. And it is what we're gonna do. Because by having those new habits, what you're gonna do, you're gonna stop thinking about your ex, you're gonna start focusing on the right things and start progressing and start changing. And this is when or where magic happens. So, actions, and that's what I'm gonna do in these videos. I'm gonna explain you a concept, and then after that, it's really about actions. We wanna be at the bottom of this pyramid. Take the quiz if you haven't done to know if you have any chance to get back with your ex. That's, I guess, the first thing you can do. You can subscribe, or you should subscribe to the channel if you're not a subscriber, so you'll be notified anytime I post a video. And this month, November 2021, I'll be posting one video per day. Yes, I'm crazy. You can also check out links in the description where you'll find other tools and resources, handouts and stuff like that. I will launch a WhatsApp group for people who want to join me in November to join this 30-day challenge and really challenge yourself to feel better, challenge yourself to do the right things, challenge yourself to learn more about yourself, and challenge yourself to get back with your ex, because that's what we want to do. Basically, any other questions, don't hesitate to ask in the comment section. It's a trial, so it's completely free. The idea is to try this approach, to try this method. So if you have any questions in the comments, if you have any ideas, if you want to contribute, don't hesitate, use that comment section in the video, and I will be seeing you tomorrow. Bye-bye.
igetmyexback.com. Everyone deserves a second chance.